So you've just opened Adobe Premiere Pro and you're feeling super overwhelmed. I mean, how many menus do they need in this program? Well, don't worry, I'm going to show you how to use Adobe Premiere Pro from start to finish in less than 20 minutes. Everything from importing your clips, adding titles, and exporting. And to make it harder for myself, let's add a timer. So before we open up Adobe Premiere Pro and start this tutorial, it's always good to have some great organization. So we've created some folders here which help organize your clips and your video and all your assets. So we've done that here, but now let's open Adobe Premiere and show you how you import your clips. When you open up Premiere, you'll see this window pop up. You want to click New Project, which opens up this box. Here we have the file name, which will be the file name of your project. For us, this is called Tutorial. Underneath, you can see the destination that this project is being saved to. Click Browse to select one. In the next tab, we have Scratch Disks, and this basically means that Premiere is going to look for our video and audio files in this destination. By default, it usually sets itself to the same as your project filed, but just in case, you can manually select the folder again if you like, and it makes the program run much faster. Once that's set, you can click Done. So this is what you first get when you open Adobe Premiere, but let me explain what each bit means. Now, your screen may not look the same as ours. Premiere can sometimes open a different layout, but you can reset that by going to Window and then Reset Workspace Area. That should fix it for you. Now we're ready to begin. Each part of Premiere is split up into sections in the order that we all work. So we start over here in the Media bin. This is where we import all of our video, music, sound effects, and graphics, and things like that. We already made our folders earlier with all of our assets already inside them, so we're going to drag and drop these folders directly into the media bin. As you can see, it's kept the assets in the correct folders, so you don't have to create folders in the bin. This is just much faster and a more efficient way of staying organized. It's important to stay organized when editing. Okay, so let's select a clip and start putting an edit together. Double click on a clip that you want and it opens in this section above the media bin. Now we're going to be working here. This is where you preview clips and select which part of the clip we want to see in our edit. So to do that, we have to make an in point and an out point. We can do that by using the keyboard shortcut I to mark in and O to mark out. Just remember I and O and you're good to go. That's pretty much the main core of video editing. You can see here this gray bar that's just been made since creating those points. This is now the selection of video that we will see on the timeline. Now we could go ahead and manually create a sequence for this video, but if we just click and drag our clip from the preview window to our timeline here, Premiere will automatically create a sequence using the same settings as our video clip. This makes it much easier to work with, especially if you don't know much about frame rates and resolutions. And if you don't, we'll be teaching you more of that later on. Now, we have this clip on the timeline and it's created a sequence. You'll notice that we have a sequence file in our media bin, but it has the same name as the clip we just cut. We want to rename that so we can stay organized, which you can do by double clicking. If you want to be even more organized, you could create a new bin here to contain the sequence. We also have this second window that's opened with our footage on it again. This is our final output window. Anything we create on our timeline will show up here, and this will be our final video. So what if you just want the video track without the audio? In our preview window, we have these icons here. If we hover over this film strip, we'll see it says drag video only. Click and drag from that icon, and we will bring just the video clip on its own into our timeline. Now, let's do the same with a couple of other clips and get a basic edit going. The same as before, select the clip you want, create an in and an out point with I and O, and click and drag from this icon to put it onto the timeline without the audio. If you want the audio, then just click and drag from the video preview itself.
So as within any project in real life, you need the right tools for the job. I'm going to show you how the cutting tools work.
We can continue to make cuts on the timeline. We don't have to get it perfect in our preview window. If we hover over to the ends of the clip, you can see you get this arrow up here. We can drag this in and out to shorten or extend the clip. We also have the razor blade tool, and you can hit C on your keyboard to bring it up. The razor tool spits our clip wherever we want. So we could make a cut here and then select the end and hit backspace to delete it. Next, we have our ripple edit tool, which you can hit B on your keyboard to activate. It works like our first tool, with the arrow appearing at the beginning or the end of our clip. Only now, when we trim the clip, all of the clips after it will automatically move into place, so we don't have to manually move them to fill the gaps. Now, let's continue to create more of a sequence. We're going to speed this part up so you don't get bored of watching. We're just using the same process as before. Okay, so here's our sequence we've put together. Now let's give it some life by adding some music. We can't provide you with the music we're using because you need a license for the tracks that you use, but everything we've got here is from Epidemic Sounds, which has thousands of royalty-free music and sound effects that you can use in your project. We'll leave a link in the description. We use the same process for audio as we do with video. Select it in your media bin and make your in and out points on the part of the track you want to use, and then just drag and drop it into the timeline in the audio section.
So our timeline is coming together really nicely now. We've added our music, but let me show you how to add some sound effects in. I mean, we've got trams and traffic here, so let me show you how we can add those types of noises into this project.
So we found some nice sound effects on Epidemic Sounds that match the environment that we're in. Things like city traffic, trams, and things like that. We're using the same techniques again, selecting the tracks, making in and out points, and dragging to the timeline where we want them. You can also use multiple layers on the timeline with both video and audio. Just drag your clips and place them above or below a layer that already has something on it. If you run out of layers like we have here, just pull the clip down here until you see this icon appear, and it will create a new audio track when you release.
So some music or sound effects you bring into your project can actually end very sharply. So what I'm going to do is show you how to add some nice fade in and fade outs to the music.
So let's blend all of these sounds together with some fade transitions. So let's go into our effects tab over here and type in fade. We have these options here, and we want to select the exponential fade. Click and drag it onto our clip, and there we go. You can adjust the length of the fade by hovering over it on the clip and dragging it in or out. Repeat that process if and when you need it to add in more sounds.
So we've added some transition effects into our audio, but what if you want to add some transitions to your video? If you want to fade in your videos or add some swipes, let me show you how to do that.
With your clip selected, hit Command plus D on your keyboard and it will automatically add a fade. You can adjust the duration by dragging it along your clip. We can also add a fade between two clips by selecting them both at the same time using Shift. Use the same keyboard shortcut and there we go. But be aware that sometimes this adds a fade effect to the beginning and the end of the clip. But you can remove one just by selecting it with a clip and hitting delete. You can also adjust the position of the fade by clicking on it and dragging it into position.
Okay, so next up is color correction. If you want to make some subtle adjustments to the look of your film, I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, in this tutorial, we don't have enough time to go over it in too much depth, so make sure you subscribe to the channel so we can show you an in-depth tutorial on color correction. But let's go into the basics.
So go over here to where it says color, and this opens our Lumetri color panel. If it's grayed out, it means you don't have a clip selected, so make sure to have the clip selected that you want to make adjustments to. Now we can adjust things like exposure and contrast, and even go crazy and change the colors in a scene. But what if you want to make some color adjustments to the whole timeline? Well, you can easily do that by creating an adjustment layer over here. Drag that onto a layer above all of your footage and extend it to fit. Now, when we go into the color panel, any adjustments we make affect every clip on the timeline. So this is where we can add a color preset to give it that unique film look, which you can find in the Creative tab here. We're not going to go into much color grading here because it would honestly take a very long time, but stick around or subscribe to the channel and we'll make a future video on advanced color grading. You can toggle on and off the color adjustments so you can see before and after by hitting this little eye icon on the timeline. This makes that video layer invisible, and this also works on all video layers. we're going to use one of our own custom LUTs for speed. And a LUT is basically just a pre-made color adjustment that you can add to color with. It makes things really easy. You can adjust the intensity of the preset with this little slider here. Now let's add the finishing touches with some titles. To do that, we need to go into our graphics tab here. And then select our text tool over here, which you can access much faster by hitting T on your keyboard. Now we can click anywhere in our output window and start typing out our title. Then we can switch back to our selection tool by hitting V on the keyboard. And now you can move your title into position. If you want to be precise, you can go over into the properties in the graphics panel over here and then use the alignment tools. These instantly place your title in the center of the frame. And this properties panel is where you can create all kinds of custom effects to your titles and graphics. We can also change the font down here and the font size and letter spacing. Down here, we can choose the color of our text, and we can also add a drop shadow to separate it from our video a little bit more. So that's the title made, but what if we want to fade it in like our video does? No problem, we can just use the same method as we did earlier with our fade transition. Just hit Command plus D or Control plus D to add that fade, and it's as easy as that. Okay, so let's take a look at our final video before we go to export it. Okay, so that's the entire edit done, start to finish. But now what? It's time to render. Go to File, Export Media. Or if you're into your keyboard shortcuts, and you should be, you can hit Command, Control, M in your timeline to bring up the render window straight away. Okay, so over here is where we select a format and give our video a name and a destination to export to. Click on the blue file name to create a file name and its destination. It's really good practice to save it into the same destination we created at the beginning of the video. Just makes everything easier to find. And you may want to add a new folder in there called renders. So you want to make sure that you're rendering it with the maximum render quality and then hit export. And that's it. Now, there are loads of different file formats and render settings you can use for video. And there isn't the time for us to go through all of them in detail, but we'd recommend using H.264. In our next video, we're going to go into great depth on render settings and the best ones to use for YouTube and social media. It's different for all situations, so make sure you give that video a watch.
Whew, that's our Premiere Pro project done and dusted, and we've shown you how to use Premiere Pro from start to finish in less than 20 minutes. But if you want to know more about Premiere, things like export, things about effects and titling, make sure you stick around and watch our next videos and subscribe to our channel, because we're going to have a ton of Adobe Premiere Pro videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.